Why hasn't Elon Musk been to space? Jeff Bezos decided to mark the first success of the long-running New Shepard project with a flight to space, literally. And Richard Branson recently did the same with Virgin Galactic. However, something is off with the CEO of SpaceX, Elon Musk. Despite having made so many breakthroughs in space travel, Elon Musk has never once taken a trip to space. But why is that? Well, we'll find out in just a second. But before that, please subscribe to Futurephile to watch more fascinating videos on futuristic tech. Done that? Well, let's get right into it. Elon Musk was at Kennedy Space Center in Florida on the day SpaceX's first space tourist launched, clapping as the private astronauts went to the Teslas that would transport them to suit up. Musk was there to congratulate them in person after they successfully landed after orbiting Earth 45 times. The Inspiration 4 mission was SpaceX's fourth successful human spaceflight, and a SpaceX executive stated that the firm hopes to launch paying customers 3, 4, 5, and 6 times a year at the very least. In this era's commercial space race, Musk SpaceX led on almost every metric except one, giving the CEO a lift above the atmosphere. Branson and Bezos accomplished it, so why hasn't Musk done it yet? After all, he is the only person on the planet who, if he so desired, could launch his own rocket into space. He could spend a whole week just admiring the scenery from the Dragon capsule while putting the other space millionaires to shame. So if it's so easy for him to do compared to the other billionaires and competitors that have done it, why hasn't he done it yet? Well, only Elon Musk can explain why he hasn't followed in the footsteps of fellow billionaires Richard Branson and Jeff Bezos to make a brief journey to space. However, Marina Koren of the Atlantic proposed one idea, and it's a very easy one. Koren talked with Garrett Reisman, a retired NASA astronaut and engineering professor at the University of Southern California, who currently works as a senior consultant to Musk SpaceX. Musk did pay a deposit for a future trip on Branson's Virgin Galactic, but the business, like Bezos' Blue Origin, only provides suborbital flights. In addition, Blue Origin has contended that Virgin Galactic's flights do not truly qualify because Blue Origin travels higher. Musk could, without a doubt, declare himself an astronaut while flying in SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft. Surely his team could whip together a spacesuit in his size, and Musk isn't renowned for being afraid to take risks. In 2015, he stood erect atop a soaring jet in a feat known as a wing walk. Despite this, Musk has stayed securely on Earth during the summer of Space Millionaires. Garrett Reisman also has some insights. Reisman is a senior advisor to SpaceX, where he previously worked on the company's program to transport NASA astronauts. Early on, Reisman met with Musk to discuss some specifics about future crewed flights. Boeing, which was developing its own system with NASA's help, had decided that its first test flight would carry one NASA astronaut and one astronaut employed by Boeing. That flight has yet to happen because of hardware and software issues. Reisman said that a similar arrangement could be good for morale at SpaceX. The chance to become a company astronaut would surely energize the workforce. And he looked right at me and he said, "Why would anyone want to go to low Earth orbit?" What Reisman took from that exchange was that Musk didn't find it so impressive to reach low Earth orbit, where hundreds of satellites, the International Space Station, and most astronauts who have been to space have spent their time. Musk certainly understands the stakes, and he wants SpaceX to do spaceflight as well. After the first astronauts to test drive the Dragon came home last year, beating Boeing to the milestone, Musk said that he's not very religious, but I prayed for this one. But he has always been focused on the Moon and on Mars. In Musk's mind, humanity should already have a base on the lunar surface, and he founded SpaceX 2 decades ago because he was aghast at NASA's lack of progress on a Mars mission. Musk's goal remains to reach and building a city on Mars and, as he often says, making life multiplanetary. Reisman further said that if launching on Dragon's next flight would mean moving close to that future, Musk would do it. He's not only interested in the thrill of it, Reisman said. Musk has said in the past that he does intend to fly on a Dragon one day, but it might be more his style to choose a journey that signifies a major step in human expansion into space. A few former SpaceX employees suggested that Musk might board one of the first crewed flights of Starship, the spacecraft that SpaceX is developing to reach the Moon and Mars. That would certainly be a bit more momentous. Then again, Elon Musk is in a league of his own. Unlike Bezos and Branson, Musk does not have a pressing need to demonstrate the capabilities of his rockets and capsules. SpaceX is already one of the world's most dependable spaceflight firms, and its Falcon 9 rocket is regarded as an industry workhorse. Bezos intended to show that if Blue Origin were safe for him, it would be safe for his customers. But Musk had already proven SpaceX's safety by launching professional astronauts. So is there any point in improving anything by jumping on one of the rockets and traveling to low orbit space? Musk is also not the showman that Branson has always been or that Bezos has become. He is more likely to go off on jargon-laden tangents about rocket engines. Musk still has a lot of work to do on Earth and is bound by restrictions. On Monday, shortly after visiting with the Inspiration 4 team in Florida, he boarded his private jet and returned to South Texas, where engineers and technicians are hard at work on Starship. With the look of things, he surely hopes to fly a prototype into orbit by the end of the year. Simultaneously, Musk is promoting electric vehicle research at his other cherished firm, Tesla. Tesla, in contrast to SpaceX, is a publicly listed business with a board of directors. And while Musk hasn't always been the most well-behaved CEO, spaceflight would take him to a whole new level of brash. Bezos resigned as Amazon CEO only days before his journey this summer, and while he told CNN that he could have done this flight as CEO of Amazon and it would have been fine, there was some suspicion that his suborbital excursion was just too hazardous for someone in his position. An orbital spaceflight is a whole different affair, with far higher hazards. Many former SpaceX employees also believe, in contrast to others, that Musk will not travel to space until he believes Tesla and SpaceX can function without his personal efforts. Even if SpaceX reaches Mars in his lifetime, Musk is unlikely to be among the first individuals to set foot on the planet. He has also stated that he would like to die on Mars, just not on impact, and the initial missions will be the most dangerous. It is difficult to picture Musk, who is notorious for his absurdly long work weeks, giving up his other interests, or even enjoying a week-long vacation in low Earth orbit. If he remains behind long enough, the individual who has the potential to alter humankind's position in space drastically may not make it there himself. It would still not be without merit to expect Elon Musk to make a trip to suborbital space in the very near future. One of the most important things to remember, though, is that Musk works for SpaceX on a very different basis compared to Bezos and Branson. He has to answer to investors directly and also has to maintain crucial employees such as Gwynne Shotwell. In the end, Musk may find an opportunity to go up to space and cement his legacy once and for all if everything with the Starship goes according to plan. Well, if you like this video, you may also enjoy this next video that is shown in the end screen. I'll see you there.